G'day, iRock from Down Under here. Today I'm casting another team game I played with Chris Becker. This time I'm playing as the Bulgarians. Chris is going to be playing once again as the Celts. And as you can see, I am going to do another TC drop. And as such, I won't be needing all these extra cows, so I'll be sending 6 over to Chris. As you can see, we're very close to one another. The enemy are also very close, so that should make for an interesting situation if we're both going to be aggressive early, as we plan to be. So let's fast forward through the Dark Age.
Yes!
I found my boar. That's the first boar. So once I finish my boars, I'm going to be looking for the enemy base so I can TC drop it. We're hoping that I can TC drop the Franks, and that's going to be the case. Frankish player was walling up, but decided to abandon that when he saw my TC. And he loses a fill. I'm immediately out to begin raiding Frankish woodline, which I know is over here. So we both lost fills there. I think he's decided to abandon his TC. It's already be garrisoned any longer, and yes, he's going to build a defensive wall to try to keep me out. So this is basically half the size of the team fortress that our opponents were trying to build. You can see that this was the other half of the team fortress, which has now been abandoned. He's rushing up a stable, which is what we expected from the Franks. He's actually managed to get a wall up, and aside from, I think there's a gap here, these vills over here of mine are now stuck in the enemy base. I think they are completely stuck actually. There's another palisade wall there, and I'm learning the extent of this team fortress, which they've just completed now. And these vills will seem to be doomed. So I figure I may as well fight the archers. Now Chris has come over here and he's already broken in. He's got 6 men at arms and he's made a sneaky base down here in the corner. He's producing men at arms. 7 men at arms now. I've made another TC to deny this wood line here. And I'm trying to break in. I'm trying to save these last 2 builds, but unfortunately they can't quite make it, so they're going to be cut down. But Chris has found the Mayan's woodline, and he's denied that. The Mayans have another woodline over here though. We also have 3 archers. And are pumping out more to come and deal with this. And Chris doesn't have the armor upgrade yet. I'm sure he's working on it. Oh, and there's too many archers here, I think, for him to deal with. And the TC fire especially, he'll have to back away. But he can deny the wood line if he wants. Meanwhile, I'm still trying to break in. I have a few vills on berries here. And actually that was the opponent who had a few vills on berries. My vills are on berries down here, and I've got still 4 on wood. I have plenty of wood though. begin by attacking the stables, whereas Chris now has the armor upgrade, so that'll be a much better fight. But this is too many archers. Decided just to build another TC. It looks like it's going to be quite a while before I can get in. So a TC here will help to deny some of this gold and make this stable virtually worthless. Take some of these berries. And now Chris is back. He has some scones. So this will be a much better fight. These archers are in a lot of trouble. Stable goes down. This loses two men at arms, but these archers are forced to run away from the skirms. Take out this other stable. And I think I've discovered the enemy has some bills back here. There'll be some bill fighting going on soon. And here comes Chris's skirms to deal with these archers. There's a lot of skirms, but most of them aren't in the action. And we can see that the Mayans player has clicked up to castle. I'm still in Dark Age. And Chris and the Franks are in feudal. Skirms of their own, and these archers are dying. Mines reach castle age. Now we have these few scouts from the Frankish player coming over to help. They're going to be very annoying, it seems. I find them clicked up to feudal age. There's a skirm battle going on over here, and the scouts are just running away from the men-at-arms. Okay, so it looks like there's a bill fight over here, which I won, and sent my bills to stone, now going to gold, and taking the deer and the berries. For some reason have sent some bills over here. I think they want to take this gold. This gold is apparently too dangerous for them. They're building a TC there though. I finally arrived in feudal. And I'm rushing up a market. Neither of us are in castle, and we need one of us to be in castle, so I'm going to sling some food over to Chris. It'll be a while before I get the gold to be up into castle age. But there we go. Let's have a look at Chris's perspective. Yes, he has tons of resources now. He's clicked up to castle. And with all these resources, I would expect him to be producing some more troops or getting some crucial upgrades. Perhaps he's waiting until Castle Age comes in. Looks like he's got a good fight here, and he's controlling this gold, placing a town. Scouts are trying to raid my farming eco, they'll get a bill kill. Just gonna wall up with stone and scouts just to bail through what is apparently a gap in the wall. And Chris's skirms this gold, and my tower over here is denied this gold, except that it's one build. Now we have a Frankish army of 6 scouts, which are going to annihilate these scouts unless they jump in the tower. No. And Chris arrives in Castle Age.
Have a love.
Really idling a lot of the eco for the Mayans and even for the Franks, who also arrived in Castle Age. I sent Chris some more gold, which is excess. I'm about to climb to Castle Age soon, I think, once I can get my farming eco moving again. These builds are going to build some towers. Chris is still denying this gold, so mostly it's that stone and a little bit of this gold which our opponents are taking. TC is shooting down the scouts. And our ecos at home are fairly safe. Chris's home eco is much more impressive than mine. And the scouts are trying to deny this tower, but this gate should put an end to that. TC is shooting down the scouts still. And they're trying to raid, but there's really nothing for them to raid over here. Everything is safe. Out on the field for both Chris and for the Mayans. So Celt Mangonels win the day, not surprising. And these crossbows are in trouble, but they back away. Now we have a lot of Mayanvilles building a castle, and a Mangonel arrives. It's a Celtic Mangonel too. This could be disastrous. Yes, lots of Vils are dying. And if not for these scouts, I'd say that castle would not have gone up. Still might be denied. More Vils will probably die. Now these 3 scouts have done a lot of work, and that castle is quite crucial. Okay, that gives them a lot of protection in this area and really forces this attack to perhaps find a new way in. Meanwhile, both towers are up and they've been doing some work on these Frankish builds, slowly denying some farms and gold and killing off villages. Meanwhile, I have the eco to go castle. I haven't clicked up yet. I think I'm waiting on a blacksmith, which is up, And now I click up. Okay, Chris's attack is now focusing on STC, trying to take it down with his Mangonel. Meanwhile, he has two towers to protect. Longswords are running under the TC fire. Now we have a Mangonel from the Franks, as well as Frankish Knights. And yes, they should clear this.
Yes.
Looks like this tower will fall, and this tower should follow, and this side attack from Chris has stalled and his men-at-arms are heading, or longswordsmen, are heading back to his base. So just as they were looking safe, I arrive in castle. And I was about to build a crepost right there, but at the same moment, Franks began to build a castle. However, I have 11 vils building it already, my crepost, which will go up much faster. The Frankish player, I think, is seeing the danger, and he's starting to bring some more villagers over. He's got 13, but I should win this race. Let's see. Like I killed 5 Frankish villagers. Now all our bills are stuck inside these now. The Franks do have a siege workshop. They made a siege Mangonel before. So it will be a race to see who can take down the defensive fortification. And there is the Frankish workshop. I already have a siege workshop up and I'm making battering rams. I'm going to make another crepost here to defend. And the Frankish position, what's left of it, is under heavy siege. Almost all of the Frankish eco is ranged by my two creposts here and my tower. Stop this battering ram taking down the Frankish castle. However, they can't get close. They're just going to lose. And they do die. They really need to come in from the other side, but they haven't done that. So slowly that castle will be rammed down. More rams are coming in. Have a look at the Frank player. He has 9 bills left. And looks like he has 3 knights, which we saw are coming home. Now we've got a large force here of skirms and crossbows heading over to Chris's base. But the Frankish castle falls, and the Franks are down to 8 bills. over here, but fortunate that I decided not to when I saw this castle going up. And all my villas are gonna build this Grepos to try to race this Mayan castle up. The Mayans have built a castle over there already. So I have 31 villas building this Grepos versus 9 building this Mayan castle with a head start, but it still falls far short and all those villas will die. Two Krepos here, and a Conic, and the bills are getting cut down. Castle is rammed down. I've decided to mine some more stone, but unfortunately, these Frankish knights are headed in that direction. This force doesn't seem to have engaged yet. Now they come in. Chris has sent a lot of military over here to attack the Mayans. My Vils had to retreat. Meanwhile, Chris's farming eco is being raided. But the Mayans are losing their castle near YTC. And their position is looking very weak. Chris is rushing up the castle on the other side, and they are very handy. And this was once their most the weakest part of their base, and now it seems to be the safest corner. The Mayans have lost their castles, and I'm heading back to work. Some stone, and I try to go again for the stone, but that doesn't work. Are running away, trying to build an alternative base, I would imagine. And these bills are also bailing. Slowly getting whittled down. He's having to back away. Mine bills running all over the map. Chris is making havoc with his longswords. And mine player calls it. As the French TC has also fallen. So I won the military and Chris won the economy. The military, I only lost 15 units and killed 88, so I was very happy with that KD. And Chris had a very solid KD as well. The eco, you can see Chris won the eco except for the stone. The Mayans mined a lot of stone, they put two castles up near my base. I was slowest to castle age and to feudal age by a long way. Mines won both races, but that 7 minutes didn't really help them to do much to push back the trap that they found themselves in. I had only, well, no castles, but I had quite a few Krepos. And we had bigger villager highs than both our opponents. And you can see red really never recovered from that early pressure. It's just constant pressure, and towards the end had very few villagers. Chris made quite a few raiding forces and seemed to always have the upper hand militarily over the Mayans, and I guess my job was to form one part of the trap and put a lot of pressure on the right flank of our opponents, which was the Franks. Okay, well, that was it for this game. Thanks for watching. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video.